This is a special test to see how well the new A6 fares in its class. The classic rivals from BMW and Mercedes are there to measure themselves against the newcomer. This is a prestigious comparison between three premium sedans. Those in the higher echelons at Audi are already sure of the outcome. Seldom has the car maker from Ingolstadt been so certain about one of its creations like the new A6. And since first impressions often make the greatest difference, Audi hired star designer Walter De Silva to pen the lines for the new sedan. The Audi A6 for model year 2004 measures 4.90 m in length, longer than any of the former models. The 530D is the class leader in one sense, but not in a positive way. It's the highest priced car in today's trio, selling for €47,150 in Germany, and that's only its basic price without any extras. What you get for that amount is probably the freshest and most visionary looking car in its class. That becomes evident as soon as you put it next to the Mercedes. 2 years after the launch of the E-Class, much of the sparkle has already gone out of its star. Still, the E-Class continues to be the best-selling model in the premium mid-range. The 3.2-litre turbo diesel enjoys great popularity in the E320, even if it is the weakest in the test with its 204 horsepower. The BMW 530D seems better equipped. Its straight six produces 218 horsepower. Audi's 3-litre TDI may run on 7 horses more, but it has to carry around 2 heavy tons of curb weight. In the end, the numbers game results in almost a tie. All three hit the 100 mark in just under 8 seconds. On the slalom course, clear differences are evident. The Mercedes shows strong signs of roll in curves, is lethargic but easy to manage. Sporty and firm, on the other hand, the chassis of the all-wheel drive Audi A6. With a slight tendency to understeer and with much less body movement, the Audi manages to keep ahead of the Mercedes. But only until the BMW appears on the scene. Its active driving dynamics and neutral handling place it back in the position it enjoyed before the new A6 arrived, namely at the top. Let's move away from the tests and on to normal situations. On winding country roads, the powerful and refined engine in the Audi A6 is loads of fun, especially mated with the 6-speed automatic transmission. The heavy weight is a big drawback, however, pushing consumption up to 10.3 litres of diesel per 100 kilometres. Even all the operations of the MMI computer system available at the turn of a knob are no consolation. The 5 Series once again can be said to give you the ultimate driving pleasure. This time, even in one further sense, a particle filter makes it friendlier to the environment. Its active steering, on the other hand, is still an issue of controversy. The E-Class is famous for its ride comfort. Its suspension glides over any surface irregularities, yet unfortunately the relaxed ride is disturbed by the comparatively unrefined engine. Munich, Ingolstadt or Stuttgart. Which city the car comes from is mainly a question of taste. The Mercedes is rather conservative, while well-crafted with a solid build. It's a reasonable choice, that is if you ignore the price. €46,214 is hardly a bargain in Germany. That price includes a well-equipped executive sedan with good fuel economy and adequate overall comfort. The downside, its rather sluggish engine and its unemotional handling. One point the new A6 can certainly boast about is its space. There's plenty of room for both passengers and cargo. The stylish and top-quality interior is also impressive. Even more astonishing, the basic price of €42,900. That puts loads of pressure on the other two contestants. The strengths of the Mercedes are the weak spots of the Audi. Comfort and consumption of the new A6 are in definite need of improvement. Avant-garde, design, innovation. Those are three words that tell us what the current BMW 5 Series is all about. You either love it or hate it. You just have to love it for its cultivated and powerful engine and its sporty nature, not to mention the comfort it offers its occupants. The only disappointing thing about this Beamer, its steep price. The final outcome of this comparison should come as no surprise. Even if its lead is only extremely small, the BMW still manages to put the new A6 in its place. And as for the E-Class, it's high time for a makeover.